This is one farm in Hyderabad where he has developed a small litter lemur loader, a tractor loader, which is costing about 3 to 4 lakhs. Because this is an example where people cannot manually remove the litter, they can mechanize it and they can pick the litter from the sheds, because there is no side mesh and side walls the commercial farmers generally don't put. So they have access for the tractor to get in and they remove the litter, at least after the removal of the flock. Because today with the bird flu scare, we are not allowing outside vehicles to come and pick the litter from our sheds. We are trying to remove them and put in a separate place. So this kind of equipment will definitely help you. And coming to the very interesting topic, my friends were saying in the audience that you have shown it as an egg. Which egg to pick? Either the fly eggs or the chicken eggs. So chicken eggs, we know very well that that is a revenue, and we take a lot of care about egg collection and maintaining and transporting them. But very interesting topic here is that the fly eggs. Because unless you concentrate on the litter closely, if you look at that, you cannot make out where the eggs are. Fortunate for us is that flies lay eggs in clusters. So when you look at from distance, they look like white or light brown color. But when we use a simple magnifying lens, we can make out they look like this. They look like exactly similar to a rice grain. So with some practice, laborers, we could train in our farm, laborers are trained within 2 days. And the gentleman who suggested me also, both are here, they have given me this advice and we started applying it from 1 month. Mr. Manohar and Satyanarayan Reddy from Andhra Pradesh, they suggested me this idea. So from next day we started practicing it. It is helping a lot. It looks very silly also. Sometimes we may not find it logical, but it is working. We are doing it. When we identify the eggs and remove with a small iron piece or asbestos sheet, you can simply throw it out of the shed or properly put it in the bags and dispose it off. Then that's it. Because we know very well that eggs require 70% moisture for them to hatch. So when you are just putting out of the shed, that is finished. Those eggs are gone. They are dead. They will not hatch to larva. And another good idea we got from the industry is that the larvae generally which grow in this wet litter, they migrate and pupate on the sites. So there are people who are collecting this larva and pupa, engaging labor. I will come to the costing of it. You must be wondering, how is it possible? We don't have labor to pick the eggs itself. So we have some calculations on this. I will show you that. So I have calculated the cost of removing litter by employing labors. This is cost for litter removal twice a week. This is a cost for removal of eggs, larva and pupa on a daily basis. When I say daily, you will wonder, how is it possible? The labor required, I put it as 2 to 3 days, because I want to be very safe. My friend from Andhra Pradesh, he says, is 1 lakh capacity, it is 1 lakh plus. He engages only one gentleman. His job is to collect eggs every day at specific timings. That is 10 o'clock and 4 o'clock. These flies have got a habit of laying eggs at 10 o'clock in the morning, 4 o'clock in the evening. So engage a labor from 10 to 11 and 4 to 5. They do a good job. By removing these eggs, we can reduce the fly population by 40 to 50%. So these are two methods. If you have more labor, you can remove the litter twice a week, which people in Bangalore are doing, in AP few people are doing. Even I myself am trying in my grower unit, where the litter quantity is less, I am trying with my labor. And for all these calculations, the labor cost is taken as 5,500 per month, and one person can remove litter from 3,000 birds.